गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वार्मली वेलकम्स ऑल ऑफ यू इन टुडेज लेक्चर व्हिच इज ऑन द सेम टॉपिक कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट आर कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, देन हाउ आर दे क्लासिफाइड एंड आल्सो वी हैव स्टडीड द नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू IUPAC सिस्टम। फ्रेंड्स, in my today's lecture we are going to study the reactions of monosaccharides and that involves glucose and fructose. So the reactions are here ozone formation with mechanism, then oxidation of glucose as well as fructose, then reduction of glucose and fructose, ether formation, addition reaction. And the remaining part of this topic that will be covered in next period, and these points are here, that is the open and cyclic structure of glucose, then mutual rotation with mechanism, epimerization, then interconvergence and manufacture of sucrose, that is sugar from sugarcane. So let us see the reactions of monosaccharides of say here glucose and fructose. Our first reaction is the ozone formation. Now this ozone formation is nothing but the reaction of glucose or fructose with excess of phenylhydrazine. So when glucose or fructose is treated with excess of phenylhydrazine, then we get corresponding ozones. So if the glucose is used as a starting material and it is then treated with excess of phenylhydrazine, then we get glucosazone. And if fructose is treated with excess of phenylhydrazine, then we get fructosazone. So we have to study its mechanism. Now there are two types of mechanism. First is given by Fischer and second is the modern method, which is given by Wiegand. So let us see one by one glucosazone and fructosazone formation along with its mechanism. So first of all, see here the formation of glucosazone, that is the ozone formation of glucose, and this is given by Fischer. So according to Fischer, glucose when warmed with excess of phenylhydrazine, then first of all it forms phenylhydrazone by condensation with aldehyde group. And this reaction does not stop at this stage. So the adjacent the CHOH group then oxidized by second molecule of phenylhydrazine, and itself this phenylhydrazine undergoes reduction to form the aniline and ammonia. And the resulting carbonyl group that reacts with the third molecule of phenylhydrazine and that forms the final product, which is known as glucosazone. Now let us see actual mechanism. So here the structure of glucose, that is here aldehyde group, C double bond OH, then CHOH and CHOH three times and the CH2OH. This is the structure of glucose. And when it is treated with phenylhydrazine, so this is the molecule of phenylhydrazine C6H5NH2, then this oxygen from this carbonyl group, that is aldehyde group, and this H2 from this NH2, it is given out as water molecule, and we have the product glucose phenylhydrazone. So this remaining part, that is, gets attached to this doubly bonded carbon, and we have this product which is known as glucose phenylhydrazone with the loss of one water molecule. Now this glucose phenylhydrazone then reacts with the second molecule of phenylhydrazine, and here this adjacent CHOH group that will be oxidized to carbonyl group, and this phenylhydrazine molecule undergoes reduction and forms this aniline and ammonia. So we get the product which is known as phenyl hydrazone of glucosone. So this CHOH group is oxidized to carbonyl group. Now this phenyl hydrazone of glucosone then reacts with the third molecule of this phenyl hydrazine, and here this H2 from this NH2 and the oxygen from this carbonyl, it is given out as this water molecule, and we have the final product. This is known as the glucosazone. So all these steps given above, they are given by Fischer. So this mechanism is known as the Fischer mechanism, and the melting point of this glucosazone is 205 degree Celsius. So all the above steps in order to explain the mechanism are given by Fischer. That's why this mechanism is known as Fischer mechanism. Now its alternative mechanism, which is known as modern method or Weigand method for osazone formation. So according to this Weigand, first step is common like Fischer. So here also glucose on warming with excess of phenyl hydrazine forms glucose phenyl hydrazone by condensation with aldehyde group. So it is the common step. Now here second step is different here. So this glucose phenyl hydrazone undergoes intramolecular rearrangement as Amadori rearrangement and forms cyclic intermediate which decompose to yield iminoketone. Now this reaction does not stop at this stage. The iminoketone reacts with second molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms another intermediate with the loss of water molecule, and the resulting intermediate finally reacts with third molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms the final product, which is known as glucosazone. Now let us see the actual mechanism. So according to this mechanism, this is the glucose molecule. Here is the aldehyde group C double bond OH. This is CHOH. Then CHOH three times and CH2OH. This is the glucose molecule. When it is reacts with first molecule of phenyl hydrazine, then this H2 from this NH2 and this carbonyl oxygen, that is given out as water molecule, and we get this glucose phenyl hydrazone. So we have this structure of glucose phenyl hydrazone, but this glucose phenyl hydrazone undergoes intramolecular rearrangement. Means here this hydrogen that migrates towards this nitrogen, and this double bond that shifts towards this, means in between these two carbon atoms, and again this hydrogen that forms a weak bond with this nitrogen of this NH, and we have this intermediate structure which is the cyclic one, and it is the adductor intermediate product which is unstable. Now this intermediate product loses aniline molecule, this C6H5NH, and this H, it is given out as C6H5NH2, and we have the product iminoketone. Means here is the C double bond O group formation occurs, this C double bond O, when this C6H5NH2, it is given out as byproduct, and we have this product, means this double bond that will shift to this position, that is carbon and nitrogen, and this bond shifts to this in between these two elements, that is carbon and oxygen. So we have this iminoketone. Now here this iminoketone reacts with the second molecule of this phenyl hydrazine, and again this H2 and this O, it is given out as water molecule, and we have the another one intermediate product, and this intermediate product finally reacts with the third molecule of phenyl hydrazine. This is C6H5NH2, it is the phenyl hydrazine, and in this reaction ammonia is given out as byproduct. Means this NH2 and the H from this NH, it is given out as NH3, and this remaining part of this phenyl hydrazine that will gets connected to this C double bond, and we have the final product, which is nothing but the glucosazone. And you know the melting point of glucosazone is 205 degrees Celsius. So this is the modern method of glucosazone formation. Now let us see the osazone formation of fructose by fissure. So this mechanism that involves the following three steps. First step is the fructose reacts with the first molecule of phenyl hydrazine and it forms fructose phenyl hydrazone by the loss of water molecule. This H2 and this O, it is given out as water molecule, and we get this fructose phenyl hydrazone. This remaining part, that's NNaCl6H5, that gets attached to this C double bond, and we have this fructose phenyl hydrazone. Now this fructose phenyl hydrazone that reacts with the second molecule of phenyl hydrazine. So this fructose phenyl hydrazine oxidizes this adjacent CH2OH group to aldehyde group with the loss of aniline and ammonia. So this primary alcoholic group, that will be oxidized to here aldehyde group, and we have this product which is known as phenyl hydrazone of fructosone. And this phenyl hydrazone of fructosone reacts with the third molecule of phenyl hydrazine. Now here this H2 and the oxygen that is from this aldehyde group, that is given out as a water molecule, and finally we have the product fructosazone. So this is the fructosazone, and its melting point is the same as the structure of glucosazone and fructosazone is same. Its melting point is the 205 degrees Celsius. And all the above steps given to explain the formation of glucosazone were given by Fischer. That's why this mechanism is known as Fischer mechanism. So this fructosazone formation involves three steps. First step is the fructose reacts with the first molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms fructose phenyl hydrazone, and this fructose phenyl hydrazone reacts with second molecule of phenyl hydrazine and that forms the phenyl hydrazone of fructosone, and finally this phenyl hydrazone of fructosone reacts with the third molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms the fructosone. So this is according to Fischer. But according to Wiegand or modern method, the mechanism is somewhat different. First step is common, that is here also fructose on warming with excess of phenyl hydrazine first of all forms the fructose phenyl hydrazone by condensation with carbonyl group. Means instead of here aldehyde, here is the carbonyl group, that is ketone group. Now this fructose phenyl hydrazone then undergoes intramolecular rearrangement as Amadori rearrangement and forms cyclic intermediate which undergoes decomposition and forms iminoaldehyde. In previous reaction in the formation of say here glucosazone, there is the iminoketone formation occurs, but in the fructosazone formation here is the intermediate iminoaldehyde. Now this reaction does not stop at this stage, and this iminoaldehyde reacts with the second molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms the another one intermediate with the loss of water molecule, and this resulting intermediate reacts with the third molecule of phenyl hydrazine and forms the final product known as fructosazone having melting point 205 degrees Celsius. Now let us see the actually reactions that involves in its mechanism. This is the fructose molecule. Its structure is shown here. That is here CH2OH, then C double bond O, CHOH three times and CH2OH. This is the structure of fructose. When this fructose reacts with first molecule of phenyl hydrazine, it loses water molecule. This H2 and this O, it is given out as water molecule, and that forms this fructose phenyl hydrazone. This is the structure of fructose phenyl hydrazone. It undergoes rearrangement and forms this intermediate product, that is the adduct, which is cyclic. So this fructose phenyl hydrazone that undergoes rearrangement means here this H that gets attached to this nitrogen, and the hydrogen of this OH that forms weak bond with this NH actually to this nitrogen, and that forms the ring structure, which is the unstable intermediate product, and it undergoes the loss of aniline molecule, the C6H5NH, and one here should be the there is one additional N. So C6H5NH and this H, it is given out as NH2 molecule, and we have the product this one is this primary this CH to OH group that is here oxidized to aldehyde group, and this C double bond O NH, and then CHOS three times CH2H, and it is known as imino aldehyde. Now this iminoaldehyde reacts with the second molecule of phenylhydrazine, and it loses one water molecule, that is this H2 and the oxygen from this aldehyde group, that is given out as water molecule, and we have this product which is the second intermediate, and this intermediate product reacts with third molecule of phenylhydrazine, and this NH2 and H from this NH, it is given out as ammonia, and this remaining group that will be gets attached to this C double bond, and we have the final product which is known as fructosazone. So the fructosazone and glucosazone have the same structure, that's why they have the same melting points, that is 205 degrees Celsius. Now let us see the second chemical property or chemical reaction. First, that is here oxidation. So oxidation of glucose here we have to study. So with weak oxidizing agent, so glucose when allowed to oxidize with weak oxidizing agent like bromine water, then the aldehyde group of the glucose oxidizes into carboxylic acid, and we have the product gluconic acid. Now let's see the reaction. This is the structure of glucose, CHO, then CHOH four times and CH2H. This is the structure of glucose. This is the weak oxidizing agent, bromine water. So it oxidizes this aldehyde group into carboxyl group, and it is known as gluconic acid. But when strong oxidizing agent like nitric acid is used, then the aldehyde group as well as the ending CH2H, or that is the primary alcoholic group, that is CH2H group, both are oxidized to carboxyl group, and we got the product which is known as glucuric acid, or it is also known as saccharic acid. Now let us see the reaction. This is the structure of glucose, CHO, then CHOH four times and CH2H. This is the glucose HNO3. This is the nitric acid, which is strong oxidizing agent that supplies the nascent oxygens. So three nascent oxygens are used for this reaction, and here this aldehyde group is oxidized to carboxyl group as well as this CH2H group that is also oxidized to carboxyl group, and we get the product which is known as glucuric acid or saccharic acid. But when fructose is oxidized using weak oxidizing agent, then there will be no oxidation of this fructose occurs. So this is the fructose molecule, CH2OH and C double bond O, and then CHOH three times CH2OH. This is the fructose molecule, and this fructose molecule does not undergo oxidation using this weak oxidizing agent like bromine water. So there is no oxidation. Therefore, this weak oxidizing agent that is used to distinguish between glucose and fructose. So this reaction that is used to distinguish between glucose and fructose, but with strong oxidizing agent like nitric acid that oxidizes fructose with the breaking of carbon chain into glycolic acid and tartaric acid. Now let's see the reaction. This is the fructose molecule, CH2H, C double bond, CHOH 2 times and CHOH and this CH2OH fructose. And with strong oxidizing agent, this molecule ruptures, break this particular carbon-carbon bond, and this carbonyl group is oxidized to this carboxyl group. So we have the product, the CH2H and this C double bond OH, which is known as glycolic acid. And this another one product, that is this terminal CH2OH, that is oxidized to carboxylic acid, as well as one CHOH group that is also oxidized to carboxyl group. So we get the another one product that is known as tartaric acid. So we get the mixture of glycolic acid, tartaric acid, when the fructose is oxidized using strong oxidizing agent like nitric acid. Now let us see the reduction of glucose. Now first of all, with sodium borohydride, NaBH4. So glucose on reduction with sodium borohydride or using this hydrogen gas in presence of palladium that gives an alcohol which is known as glucitol, commonly it is known as sorbitol. So this is the structure of glucose. CHOCHOH 4 times CH2OH, and when the reducing agent like sodium borohydride is used, or you may use anyone among this hydrogen gas you have to pass in presence of palladium, or when it is treated with sodium amalgam and water. So all these give the same product, D-glucitol and sorbitol. Here this aldehyde group that is reduced to primary OH group, that is alcoholic OH group, CH2H, and this product, it is known as D-glucitol or it is also known as sorbitol. As glucose is dextrorotatory, so this D that stands for the share D-glucitol as a dextrorotatory. Now the reduction of glucitol using hydroiodic acid and red phosphorus at 100 degrees Celsius temperature gives N-hexane. N is the normal chain. This proves that straight chain structure of glucose. So this is the evidence for the presence of open chain structure or straight chain structure of glucose. Now let's see here the next reducing agent, that is hydroiodic acid and red phosphorus. You know, glucose on reduction with concentrated hydroiodic acid and red phosphorus at 373 Kelvin, that gives the mixture of N-hexane and 2-iodohexane. See this reaction, glucose, CH2OH and CHOH 4 times CHO. This is the glucose molecule. It is treated with concentrated hydroiodic acid and red phosphorus at 373 Kelvin. Then we get a mixture of this N-hexane. This is CH3, CH2 4 times CH3. It is the N-hexane. And we also get the another product, 2-iodohexane. CH3, CH2 3 times, then CHI, CH3. This is the structure of 2-iodohexane. So this test that proves the presence of open chain structure of glucose. Now let us see the reduction of fructose. Now the fructose on reduction with reducing agent like sodium amalgam and water or sodium borohydride or catalytic hydrogenation, that gives two epimeric hexahedric alcohols like glucitol and mannitol. Glucitol is also known as sorbitol, because here the second carbon that becomes the asymmetric. So the products are epimers of each other. Let us see this reaction. This is the difructose molecule CH2SC double bond within CH2S 3 times CH2S. This is the structure of fructose. And it on reduction with sodium borohydride, or you may use sodium amalgamate water also. We get this product, that is D-glucetol and D-mannitol. Here D-glucetol only change in the configuration of this second carbon occurs. Now in this structure, this hydroxyl group is to the right side. So it is denoted as D-glucetol. And here the OH group is to the left hand side. So it is D-mannitol. So only change in the configuration of one asymmetric carbon atom occurs, or newly generated asymmetric carbon atom. So these two structures are epimers of each other. So epimers, that are nothing but the molecules which have the same molecular formula but only change in the configuration of the newly generated asymmetric center. So D-glucetol and D-mannitol are the epimers of each other. Now let's see here the ether formation. Now here methyl glucose, which is known as glucoside, that reacts with excess of dimethyl sulfate in aqueous sodium hydroxide and forms pentamethyl derivative. Here all the hydroxyl groups are converted into ether, and this process is known as exhaustive methylation. In basic medium, this methylation follows the SN2 mechanism. It means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, which is one step reaction. Means the incoming nucleophile and outgoing nucleophile, these two processes that occur simultaneously. Now let us see the reaction. This is the methyl glucoside. This is the cyclic structure. Now there are how many OH groups? 1, 2, 3, 4, and one is already here methylated. So this is the methoxy group. And when it is treated with dimethyl sulfate in aqueous sodium hydroxide, then here all the OH groups, they are methylated step by step. With the second, say here, suppose for this first molecule of dimethyl sulfate is used, then this OH group is methylated. By the second molecule of this dimethyl sulfate, in presence of aqueous sodium hydroxide, this OH group, that is methylated. Then the next molecule of this dimethyl sulfate in presence of sodium hydroxide, that methylates this third OH group. Similarly, fourth, and already this is methylated. So all the OH groups of the methyl glucose, they are methylated. So this is nothing but the ether formation reaction. So all these are the ether groups. This OCS3, ROR, that is nothing but the ether. This is the alkyl, you may consider, and this is also alkyl, and they are connected with the help of this oxygen. So it is the ether linkage. So this reaction is known as the ether formation, and this process is known as exhaustive methylation. So this is about the some points. Now let us take the review. So in today's lecture, we have studied the reactions of monosaccharides of say glucose and fructose. You know, glucose is a colorless sweet crystalline compound having melting point 419 Kelvin, and it is readily soluble in water but sparingly soluble in alcohol and insoluble in ether, and it is optically active, and it is dextrorotatory, hence its name is dextrose, and its specific rotation in a fresh solution, that is plus 112 degree, and this glucose is 3/4 as sweet as sugar cane, that is sucrose. If we consider the fructose, is sweetest of all ketone, sorry, non sugars, and it is readily soluble in water like glucose and sparingly soluble in alcohol and insoluble in ether. It is white crystalline, means fructose is white crystalline solid and its melting point is 375 Kelvin, it means 102 degrees Celsius. And the fresh solution of fructose has specific rotation minus 133 degree, which changes to minus 92 at equilibrium due to mute rotation. So here we have studied the chemical properties or reactions of glucose and fructose. So first we have studied the ozone formation with mechanism, then we have studied the oxidation of glucose and fructose using weak and strong oxidizing agent, as well as we have studied reduction of glucose and fructose, and finally we have studied here ether formation. So in this way we have completed half part of this chapter, carbohydrates. Remaining part will be continued in next video. So thank you for watching the complete video. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy and stay happy. So thank you once again. Keep it watching.